For today's reflection, we take the book of Luke's Gospel, chapter 18, verse 9 to 14. Here, Jesus addresses in a parable. He says that where two people went up to the temple area to pray, one was a Pharisee and the other was a tax collector. The Lord gives this parable for the purpose of we who grow in spiritual life doesn't manifest that we are strong in God by our devotion and with what we do. Our greatness in spirituality, our growth in spirituality is manifested to the extent we become a person of love. We begin to see God in one another. In this parable, Jesus says, there were two people went to pray. The Pharisee, he was a well-learned man. He's a very good man in the sense he was following the precepts of the Lord. He was even offering the offerings to the poor. He was controlling his body, making the fastings, everything. And then suddenly, he notices the tax collector behind him. Then he made fun of him, saying, I am not like that tax collector. He could not see God in that tax collector. Maybe the tax collector is a sinner. But it is the Holy Spirit that has drawn even the tax collector. Jesus said, no one can come to the Father unless the Father has drawn. That is the truth. As the Pharisee is invited by the Holy Spirit, the tax collector is also invited by the Holy Spirit. But the spirituality of Pharisee could not see the goodness of God in the tax collector. And God said, such kind of people, they come to the temple and pray, but I don't go with them. My blessing doesn't go with them. Because my blessings are given to those who bless others. I give my power that you may lift up those who are powerless. That's why God said to Abraham in Genesis chapter 12 verse 2, I bless you, my son, that you may bless one another. That's why in the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 4 it is written, why does God unite husband and wife in the bed? When one is cold, the another should warm up. When one falls, the another one should lift up. Yes, that is the purpose for which God unites people. God gives us the gift of family, where we stand with each other. We know one is weak, but the greatness, the power that God has given to me is to give that power to the powerless. So Pharisee did not recognize it. So he didn't receive the favor from God. With pain, he went back home. But on the other hand, the tax collector, Jesus says, he didn't even raise his eyes towards God. He was bowing down and crying, Lord, I am a sinner. I have sinned against you, Lord. I am not worthy to be called your son, Lord. But I know you are a merciful God. He never honored himself. He honored the Lord. He, by saying that I have sinned against others, he was honoring others. And he says, I am not worthy. God saw his heart and made him worthy. And God said in the parable, he blessed the Pharisee. No, he blessed the tax collector. And the tax collector went home after the prayer with the peace. Because when you humble, the Lord will lift you up. Whenever we humble and cry to God, God will give the Holy Spirit to them. The Pharisee prayed and went with the evil spirit, because in the absence of Holy Spirit, the evil spirit will enter into the life of people. And that evil spirit made him to compare himself to heaven and to put down the tax collector to the hell. But at the end, he never had the Lord. Rather, the hell became his home. Whereas the tax collector humbled himself. He sought the mercy of God. And God saw his humble heart and erased him and sent him home with his presence, with his Holy Spirit. May your prayer, may your way of life always make you to see God in you and God in one another, that we may celebrate life with each other. In Jesus' mighty name, I bless all of you to have the same spirit of this tax collector. Amen.